Okay, guys, welcome back. Sometimes what you find a lot of people want to do is they want to go after something called the OSCP, the Offensive Security Certified Professional Certification. So you're going to find that there's a lot of people who are really interested in this certification and what it takes to actually pass it. And I have to help a lot of people pass this exam because some of my customers are offensive cyber groups. Today, it's really difficult to get a red team job or what's called OCO, Offensive Cyber Operations, without already having your OSCP certification. So a lot of people, as they prepare for something called RIOT training, which is the NSA's red team course, a lot of them are trying to get their OSCP before that, before they attend the official NSA red team course. The RIOT red team course is the course that the NSA offers to validate what are called NSA accredited red teams. You have all these people who are trying to, based on where they work, trying to get their cyber operations group to be an NSA accredited red team. And to do that, they have to pass the NSA RIOT course. If you wanted to kind of like wrap your head around what that course would be like, it would kind of be like SANS 560 GPIN. It would kind of be like SANS 660, the Advanced Penetration Testing course. And it would kind of be like a little bit of exploit development, not much, real little bit. At the end of the day, it is a tough course. You know, I'd be lying if I said the course isn't tough. RIOT is tough. It's a really big learning curve to prepare for RIOT. Here you can see how the Army has a lot of people that wash out, they fail to pass. This group of people who are taking these courses or preparing for this is actually who my customer is during the day when I'm teaching all these classes. One of the certifications they often try to get is OSCP. OSCP is a lab-based hacking exam. You get 24 hours to take the exam. It's really hard to get any red team job, even a commercial red team job like Bank of America or Capital One's red team. It's really hard to get one of those jobs unless you already have your OSCP. Same thing with any of the military red teams, Army, Navy, Air Force, Marine Corps red teams, NSA red teams. It's really hard to get an interview for any of those teams if you don't already have it. What are the benefits of getting your OSCP? If you get your OSCP, you're going to get a deep technical industry recognized certification. A lot of people are really, really, really going to look at that and go, okay, this person can hack. If you're trying to get a pen testing job, it really sets you apart if you already have your OSCP. It's really proving, can you hack without Metasploit? I mean, that's the real gist of what they're trying to prove. Can you hack if you don't have Nexpose, Nessus, Qualys, and you don't have Metasploit, Core Impact, Saint, Immunity, Canvas? Can you hack without that stuff? That's really what it's trying to prove. Pentester Academy has a red team course that is more in line. I would do the, if you were really looking for that, attacking and defending Active Directory. So if you're really trying to become a red teamer, what I am telling you you should do is you should do the OSCP so that you can get the interview. This will get you a seat in the interview. The Pentester Academy attacking and defending Active Directory, that will get you the skill you need to do the job. The reason I say that is because modern networks are modern Active Directory driven with PowerShell 5 and PowerShell 6 and SharePoint. You know, that's the stuff that's in a modern network. You've got to be able to move laterally through a network and privilege escalate up to domain admin. These would be the things that I would say you need. If you really want to become a red team person, these would be the two things that I would recommend you do. it would show that you know your network hacking, you understand hacking without Metasploit, you understand basic scripting. You know, that's really what OSCP gives you, right? Then modern hacking is Active Directory, SharePoint, how well you understand PowerShell, privilege escalation, lateral movement in the environment. That's what this is going to be. Practice attacks in a fully realistic Windows environment with Server 2016 and SQL Server 7 2017. Multiple domains in forest so that you can practice moving across the forest. Now, everything you have to do is command line Windows. 23 learning objectives, 51 tasks. Can you enumerate Active Directory? Can you do local privilege escalation? Can you do domain privilege escalation? Can you do domain persistence? Can you attack trust? You know, can you do your persistence stuff? Like, this is really what you need. How well do you understand PowerShell? This is what you need. The combination of those two things will be what you need if you're really trying to get a job, not as a penetration tester, as a red teamer. Penetration testing is, can you scan, identify hosts in the environment, figure out which hosts are vulnerable, and then identify what would be the correct exploit to launch at the host? That's penetration testing. Red teaming really is about moving through networks without the requirement of a vulnerability present. So you're exploiting configuration issues inside of Active Directory or Windows so that you can move through the environment and steal data without being detected. Red teaming is about emulating state-sponsored hackers or emulating cybercrime where people are stealing money. It is not about identifying vulnerabilities in the environment so that they can be patched. It is a very different objective. Although red teamers and pen testers may use the same tools sometimes, the way that they use them is often very different. That's the key thing there. It's kind of a real difficult thing because a lot of people really don't know that to get the interview, you need the OSCP. To get the job, you need to know, be able to show me that you can hack Active Directory, SharePoint, PowerShell. So that's the real kind of things that I would say you really need to know if that's where you want to go.